tomorrow. The world's first bionic eye. The first step to creating a cure for blindness. Watch ABC's World News Tonight with Peter Jennings. This has been a presentation of ABC News. More Americans get their news from ABC News than from any other source. ABC News, now always on.
Other news when we come back. A scientific breakthrough of enormous proportion, making the cells that can make anything in the body. And technology on the cutting edge, helping the blind to see. As we said, change in the twinkling of an eye. When we come back, technology on the cutting edge, the silicon eye. Just in case you missed it. So, finally, technology. The most common cause of blindness is a deteriorating retina, a problem with the light receptors in the back of the eye. 10 million Americans have impaired vision because of it. And now, for the first time, thanks to a computer chip, scientists may be able to replace the retina. Here's ABC's Jack Smith.
When you think of computer chips, you think of computers. But what about chips in human beings? Incredible as it may seem, it is about to happen.
Scientists are trying to put chip technology into the human eye to create a sort of bionic eye. It's the first time humans and machines have been merged in this way. The leading edge of a breakthrough that soon may actually cure blindness.
We could restore vision by creating an electrical induced prosthesis to place into the eye.
Using computer chip manufacturing techniques, scientists are etching thousands of microscopic solar cells onto a tiny silicon chip, artificial sensors in place of the natural ones in the damaged retinas of blind people.
These are the little solar cells.
Right.
And there are how many of these in each chip?
There are approximately 4,000 to 5,000.
When the chip is implanted in the back of the eye and light strikes those tiny solar cells, they turn it into electrical signals that travel through the optic nerve to the brain and are interpreted as an image.
With this process, the brain, when it receives a signal, it should not be able to tell the difference, whether it came from a natural, healthy retina or from our implant.
Doctors think blind people might see something like this with the implant. And it will improve as they're able to cram more microscopic solar cells onto each chip. They've already succeeded in testing it in animals, and trials with humans in 2 years will determine if it works in blind people. Researchers think it will.
And they will actually be able to see again.
That's what we're hoping.
A potentially unprecedented breakthrough combining the latest in medicine and computer technology that may soon treat and even cure one of mankind's oldest scourges, blindness. Jack Smith, ABC News, Stanford, California.
That is our report on World News Tonight. Don't forget Nightline later. I'm Peter Jennings. We hope you have a good evening, and that we'll see you tomorrow. Good night.
Watch ABC's World News Tonight with Peter Jennings.
This has been a presentation of ABC News. More Americans get their news from ABC News than from any other source. ABC News, now always on.